today's tutorial, we're going to play with the Enlight QuickShot app. It has a really cool new feature called Sky, which allows you to add clouds to your pictures very easily. Let's check it out. Before you add clouds to your picture, let's adjust its settings first. Go to the Adjust section, and then let's bring the shadow. See how her face is kind of dark on one side? We can do this with the shadow setting. You can increase the shadow side of her face until you bring it up a little bit so it's not so harsh. See the difference? Next, let's play with the vibrance. Just add a little bit of vibrance so the colors pop. See how like extreme looks too hot? But if you just add that bit, it really helps with the picture. Now, let's add a vignette. Vignettes are really good on portraits like this because they help focus the light into our subject. So you can, it directs the viewer's eye to our subject. So this is before and after our edits. Once your picture is adjusted, you go back to the main section, and the next step is to add the clouds. Click on the sky button. Then the first step is you click on the random button. The random button allows you to bring multiple different styles of clouds at different times of the day, which is a really cool thing. And you click random until you find the cloud formation that you really enjoy, that you think you like for your picture. The cloud formation that I enjoy, so you click until you find the cloud formation that you like. Try multiple times until it really pops up. I like this cloud formation. So I'm gonna change the date of the time because I want the sky to be a little bit lighter. So I click on the time, and with this leveler, you can change the time of the day that emulates the time of the day. I want it to be earlier, like about 6 o'clock, like about 6:10. It works for me. I like that color of the sky. Once you select that, the next step is to move the clouds around. How do you do this? With the wind feature. The wind feature allows you to relocate the position of the clouds. See, I like them there. If you want more clouds or less clouds, you play with the clouds button here, and it adds more or removes some of them. Let's leave it the default. I like that. Opacity, if they're too strong, if you want it to be a little bit not so permanent, you click on that and adjust that. So that looks really good. So now we're gonna click on the before and after, and we're done.